None of this belong to you. You are living a program and saying that this is me. And you are trying to solve this, this me program, I have to improve. What program will improve? You don't have to improve the program, you have to go back to your original natural state. That's all is required. The program can be never improved because it's a society program dumped on you. Madam, clear? You saw the song of Madrasa? The Madrasa was the queen. She was an enlightened queen. And in India, whatever education, whatever knowledge we are studying now was LKG knowledge, not even and children grew up with this knowledge, and that's why India was called Bharata. You know what is Bharata?
Heavy.
Bharata means Nana. Rata means those who are shining with wisdom. And what kind of children will grow up when they shine with this wisdom, when the LKG education is like that? The children grow up into beautiful human beings, beautiful beings with the wisdom. The education was that level. That's why it's called Bharata. And that became Hindustan. Right? What is Hindustan?
Hindu people live.
That actually, Sindhustan, people say the people beyond Sindhu River. No. Sindhu means oceanic, infinity. Bindu means dot. Sindhu means infinity. Okay? People who live with the understanding that I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, I am the infinite Atma. That is called Sindhustan. It has nothing to do with the ocean. And this happened in the Indus Valley civilization. Indus Valley time, we had our Jnana of Vedic knowledge had gone to peak, the Atmadnana. That's why it became India. So the country of India, people live not in misery, but with understanding, I am consciousness. Nanu. Nanembudu. Nanalla. Ideha. Mana buddhi,
mana buddhi,
nanalla,
nanalla,
sachidanandatma,
sachidanandatma,
shivananunani,
shivananunani,
shivoham,
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 shivoham.
I am not the body,
I am not the body,
I am not the intellect,
I am not the intellect,
I am not the mind,
I am not the mind,
I am pure consciousness,
I am pure consciousness.
Shivaswarupi.
Shivaswarupi.
This was the knowledge of kindergarten children of India. Okay? And when you start understanding that, please understand whatever you think you are, all is a program. So, you don't worry about this program. You go back to your original state. You cannot solve these programs. These programs are many. They are dumped on you. Starting from the name, starting from this and that, it's dumped on you. Don't try to debug and solve these programs. Get out. So, to debug these programs, people go to psychiatrist. Okay? And he has similar programs sitting inside. Huh? So he can help you with his, some of his programs also. Take it. It doesn't solve the problem, okay? You have to just go back to Atmadnana, self-knowledge. Be free from this junk. Wholesale. You cannot remember them part by part. I don't want to get angry. Tell me, where did you learn anger from? Who told you anger? How is the anger coming from? It came from somebody. It's not yours. What is yours is the peace, which is already there. Just go back. Again and again, go back to your natural self. And this is what is called Shivalinga, Atmalinga. This is called Atmalinga Puja. Anybody has a question?
In our day-to-day lives, how do we... Now let's assume we keep going back to our natural state. So day-to-day function, what to do, what not to do, and
nothing.
What actions to take.
Who is asking the question?
Program.
Program is asking the question. You don't have to become program, you become yourself. Then a clean slate. Then you decide what is required. This is dirt, this is useful, this is not useful. A program question has no answer. Any answer you give is another program. Alright? Only for the answer for the program is, who is asking the question? Go back to your natural. That's what Ramana Maharshi did. Says, who are you? That's the only solution. Any questions, sir? Clear? Madam? Let's go to the next one. So, learn, understand that you are that. You are consciousness. Not the body, mind, or intellect. You are pure consciousness. Experience is body and mind and intellect. What is this body and mind and intellect? You will analyze further. First, understand what is the mess you are in. The mess is the programs, societal programs, generation to generation of programs are being dumped on you. You are living that and thinking that you are the program. Oh, Shashi, is good or bad? Yeah, suggestion. Is a good or bad, madam? Pushpa? Pushpa, la?
Another program.
Huh?
Good and bad is also
a program. Another program. So you are not any of the programs, okay? Divya?
Yeah.
What? What, yeah?
There's no choice for the program.
Huh? It happened, but you don't have to worry about that. You have to go back to your natural self. Right? You don't have to worry because they can't touch you. Only you can get trapped into them by illusion.
If it was a LKG knowledge, why did it disappear?
Because of LKG knowledge disappeared. Education system collapsed.
When was that?
That happened see this knowledge, to transfer this knowledge you need jnanis, enlightened beings. Okay? Quality of education is required. Everybody cannot give this knowledge, then it becomes a bookish knowledge. To teach this knowledge, a jnani is required. Ajnani cannot teach. If Ajnani teaches, he puts another program into your head.
Annoyingly.
Not annoyingly. He has many programs. Like psychiatrist if you go.
Yeah.
Okay, he'll put one more program into your, dump into your, because his programs. Mm-hmm. Adnani will dump his programs. Somewhere, Adnani could not continue. The next generation Adnani didn't come up. So then Adnani got inserted in this education system. Then he started his own chakra. So this system started degenerating. Then it became a lot of wrong practices came into the system. The untouchability, the butcher, the animal slaughter and all. Then Buddha came. So Buddha said, let me clean up this entire mess. Okay, he started practices, enlightenment practices, which are actually based on awareness, mindfulness. Mindfulness practices spread. So now people started ignoring all this Vedic culture. The Vedic education got backsided, dropped. So then what happened in the Buddha's time? The so-called system of the society collapsed. The system of society has like four orders: Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. So Brahmana is education class or teaching. Kshatriya is the warrior. Vaishya is businessman. Shudra is service, workers. So what happened to Brahmin class is because the education got ignored. Now Buddha said, Buddha didn't give focus on Vedic education. He said, practice. So the Vedic education got ignored. So Brahmin class got sidelined. So what happened was, Buddha was a very powerful, he was an emperor. And because of his influence, a lot of kings started becoming monks. When the kings started becoming monks, the kingdom started falling into, political system collapsed. The intellectual system collapsed because education got ignored. The political system collapsed because the kings started becoming monks. So instead of talking, fight, and when the enemy is coming fighting, they said peace. They got intellectual system collapsed, the education system collapsed, then rest of the society is. And many of these foreign invaders, they saw the strength of Indian education system, they attacked the Indian education system very drastically. So for example, Changis Khan, when he attacked India, okay, Nalanda University had students from 130 countries. Okay, and you know admission criteria like IIT and JEE, admission criteria is there, right? So admission into university was done by the gatekeeper. So the gatekeeper will ask 10 questions from different subjects. If you answer more than 7, you are admitted to university. The gatekeeper to become principal of that university, okay, Maha Upadhyaya, a person should be master of 64 subjects. The Changis Khan, when he attacked the university, he burned, killed all the teachers, many students were killed, and university was burned. It took only 6 months just to burn the manuscripts in the university. Now, still we have some system, something is pending, remaining, because many of the students memorized and they passed from oral tradition to generation, whatever is remaining is because of that. Then Britishers came, they systematically destroyed the education system. Right now, in addition to these programs, we are also slave to the British education system also. Okay? Doesn't matter, nothing to worry. Right? You don't have to worry about what happened. What is to be done is simple. Go back to your inner self, Shiva. Shiva Swarupa. Again and again go back, these programs will lose their strength. They will not catch you. You can catch the program, use the program. Is it simple or complicated?
Simple.
It's not complicated, okay? But if you go to lot of monks and all, they'll make it very complicated. Whatever the essence of spirituality I have told you made you simple for understanding. I have not made very complex theories, I have simplified. But essence is preserved. Not a single, the original truth is diluted. But the way I have communication, I have made it simple for you to understand. Shardi? Understood or complicated?
Simple.
Simple. You go back. You are Shiva Swarupa. Why are you getting stuck with these programs? Go and come back. Go and come back consciously. And these programs will not touch you. And you can use it. Like you change the dress, you change it. Use it. You have heard of this word called human being, right? What is this human being business? Who is a human being? Are you a human being?
Yeah.
How do you know? Are you a human being? Madam?
Yeah.
Why?
Someone called.
Are you a human being? Why?
Because I am. But we are becoming human becomings because we always want to become something else.
What is this human part? What is human?
Physical body.
Huh?
Physical body.
What is being?
Being is awareness.
Yes.
Present.
So are you human or a being?
Human being.
See, human being is a compound of two words, human and being, right? It's two in one. Are you half human, half being, or full human, no being? What
being
are you?
Being is there, human. Human is there, being is also there.
So, what are you? What are you, madam?
I'm a human being.
Human being.
What are you? Who told you you are a human being?
I can breathe.
Oh, I mean, those who don't breathe are human beings. Or everybody who breathes human.
No. But that's the, I mean,
breathing is a sign of human being? The monkey also breathes. Right?
His form is human.
The form is human. The form is human.
And the being is the chetana which makes this body.
The conscious.
Which makes it.
So now, are you human or a being?
I am being with a human body.
So, are you, Pushpa, are you human or being?
I don't know who I am.
What about you, madam?
Called as human being.
In this form.
Huh?
Human
form only.
I'm a being in this form.
Dependent.
Dependent on what?
Sometimes human.
When are you human?
Depend.
When?
And the programs are taken.
So, madam, are you human or being? Or both?
I'm being human.
Being human.
Being in Homo sapien format.
Say, the moment you think of yourself, what comes to you? Being comes or body comes?
Being.
Body. Are you a body?
No.
Why do you say you are not body?
Because we are not.
Why?
It's changing.
So what are you? Why? What are you? Are you body or not body?
We are not body.
We are beings.
Beings.
We are using our body. But when you interact with other persons, you are interacting with that person as a body. When somebody says, talks to you have become body. You have forgotten you are a being. Why? What makes difference between human being and being human?
Being is consciousness.
Hmm. Yes.
The human body.
So, what are you really? When we interact with society, we forget that we are being. Okay, we become human. The body becomes predominant communication, predominant thought, right? Yes or no? Let me ask you, anybody sitting here lived in some other city a couple of years back and came to Bangalore after some time? Many years back, which city?
Calcutta.
What about you?
Gurgaon.
So, how many years back you are in Gurgaon?
1 year.
1 year back he was in Gurgaon. Right? Now you are in Bangalore. Correct? So, 1 year back who was in Gurgaon?
Physical body. Me also.
So 1 year back, who was in Gurgaon?
Body was in.
Huh?
I was in Gurgaon.
So you were in Gurgaon. Who is you? The body. Just now you said I am not the body. I have consciousness.
I am the presence.
Huh?
Being of presence.
So being of presence. Being of presence. Gurgaon or Bangalore doesn't make a difference anyway. Who was in Gurgaon? The body was in Gurgaon. So, were you in Gurgaon?
Even the presence was also in Gurgaon.
Let me find out. So, he is saying 1 year back he was in Gurgaon. Do people agree? I mean, we'll believe that what he said. So, 1 year back, was your body same?
No.
No. Was your mind same?
No.
Was your intellect same?
No.
Then who was in Gurgaon 1 year back?
Previous
version. Who was in Gurgaon for 1 year back?
The being part only. I think automatically something constant is there between the
constant. So now you said I was in Gurgaon. Why are you referring to the body?
Being part.
So, you know, he left the body. Okay.
Even the body changed, but still the body was in Gurgaon only, right? Previous
but time. Changed body also you call the same body?
No, it's
same.
Different.
Just then you cannot say I. So, if you say I was in Gurgaon, then I has not changed. Alright? I has not changed. But he claims that he was in Gurgaon and he claims he's a body. Both are contradictory because body has changed. So you know that our body keeps changing?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Every minute the body, some cells are dying, new cells are born. Every 12 years you have a complete new body. Complete refurbished. So you cannot say 12 years back I was the same body. Gone. The mind, of course, changes from yesterday to today. Intellect changes every minute. So then what are you? Human or being? In the human part, body, mind and intellect include in the human part or being part?
Human
part.
Human part.
Okay. So all these are constantly changing. Constantly changing, can you call as you?
No.
Then what are you saying that you, I was in Gurgaon and you were in Calcutta, right? How many years back?
15.
15 years back you were in Calcutta. You were in Calcutta? Who was in Calcutta?
A different body of mind, but same being.
The body of different body, different mind also?
Yeah.
Different intellect also?
Yes.
So nothing is pending, remaining, same. Then somebody was in Calcutta that you call as being, right? Her being was in Calcutta 15 years back. Your being was in Calcutta, in Gurgaon, 1 year back. Okay, and you call your being as I, and you call your being as I, right? So, how many I's are there? I was in Davanagere. Not definitely not the body, not the mind, not the intellect. You are in Bangalore the other day?
No, I was in Bombay.
See, she was in Bombay. I was in Bombay. That being was in Bombay. That being is in where? Gurgaon. That being is in Calcutta. Okay. That being was still in Bangalore. Uh-huh. And how many places the being can be there?
Being.
How many beings are there? The being, there's no point in saying it's in Calcutta because it's everywhere.
It's
who was in Calcutta? Who was in Gurgaon? When you understand the paradox, madam? What is confusing?
Who was it?
So this is the problem, okay? What happens is our mind makes a certain assumptions and lives with that assumptions. Okay? So now the assumptions have changed, but the mind doesn't question that. The entire what you call you has changed. But mind says, same I was there. Right? So the being, his being, your being, his being, his being, his being, my being, your being, your being, your being. Where is your being? Which place is your being?
Shivamoga.
Her being was in Shivamoga. How can be the I in so many places? Because it's everywhere.
Yes.
Now 10,000 years also back also it was there. Okay? So Krishna said, come to me. Then people thought Krishna come to Krishna's body. So Krishna said, come to me because Krishna's I, which is your I. Krishna consciousness. So you started chasing Krishna. Because for you, the concept is I is body. For Krishna, concept of I is I. So Krishna says, I am being, but you say, I am body. So when Krishna said, come to me, you are chasing the body of Krishna. Krishna said, come to me means, come to I. What? Her name is Pratibha Krishna, embedded in that. She doesn't want to leave the Krishna also. So, you understand paradox. Krishna says, come to me. Definitely he said me. But for me, for him, me means being. For you, me means body. You just now told me I am in Calcutta. I was in Calcutta. I was in Gurgaon. Your concept of me is body. But if you really analyze that, the body has changed, the mind has changed, intellect has changed. What was there? Being. Being is everywhere. It doesn't say, I am here or there. Then who was in Calcutta? Being is everywhere.
Yes.
Then there's no point in saying Calcutta or London or Paris or here, no?
It's everywhere.
Then who was in Calcutta?
Human.
Huh? Human is changed, no? That human version, one year back old version, what model was there? So old model car and new model car, you say same?
No.
So her 15 year old.
Being shining through that. Body structure
that being is everywhere.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, absolutely.
Right?
Yeah.
So then no point in saying being is in Calcutta.
No.
It's obvious.
Everywhere.
It's obvious.
Yes.
Then was somebody there in Calcutta? The body is you.
Can be separate.
No. The body is not you.
No, it's not for you.
Huh.
But the being is shining through the body, no?
Yeah.
Awareness.
Sun is shining through the cloud. Sun becomes a cloud or what?
No.
My eyes are seeing through the glasses. Eyes become glasses or what?
No. It's an instrument to see.
So tell me, what was there anybody in your Gurgaon?
No, I think like it's just a memory.
I have not even taken memory. Okay, memory also will unless. What is memory? The moment you unless memory, memory will disappear. Wipe out. Whatever you call memory.
We're neither sitting here also.
Huh?
We're neither sitting here also.
We means who?
The being is everywhere, so.
Yeah. So now tell me, who is sitting?
Body is sitting.
Can
body with consciousness, it is sitting.
Ah?
Body with consciousness.
consciousness is what? But consciousness is everywhere.
Human being once again.
Chaitanya.
Chaitanya is everywhere. It doesn't sit and stand. It doesn't sleep also. See, please understand. Always we speak of I. Everybody in the world. Right? Everybody in the world speak of I. Right? I is the first person. Correct? And everybody knows I as the unchanging. Nobody says I changes. Everything else changes. Many places the wife and husband change faster than the body. Okay? But I doesn't change. Okay? Everybody knows I doesn't change. But everybody invariably confuses I with the body. Invariably. Okay? This is a universal error. Confusing I with the body. Universal error, not individual. And it is called original sin.
Original sin.
Confusing I with the body. I is never the body. And it's a universal error. Every time you speak of I, you are speaking of the unchanging universal consciousness. Okay? And every time you speak of the I, you confuse with the body. So in one single word, sentence, you are speaking two things. You are saying, I am unchanging I, you are saying, because I was there in Calcutta. At the same time, say, I am the body. You are speaking half truth. When you say, I was in Calcutta and I am here, you are right. I has not changed. Okay, that unchanging I is called Shiva. God, Brahman. Changing I, which you are confusing with the body and mind, is called Jiva. Now, how many I's we have? How many I's you have? All mathematical engineering students. You understood the problem or not? Huh? Tell me the solution. Now, engineering students are supposed to solve the problems. Now, everybody is... Kriti, artha idinte problem? Kirti. What problem? What did you understand? See, whatever we say that I was there, everything is actually changing. See, there are two parts to us. One is changing part, unchanging part, right? Okay, changing part, continuously changing part, which is body, mind, intellect, which is, I call it changing I. And unchanging part, which is unchanging I. What are you, changing or unchanging?
Unchanging.
Huh? Unchanging. Unchanging. Didi? Are you sure or not sure? If you say unchanging, you don't have to worry about body weight. Tomorrow we will diet, you don't worry. You have to make a choice. Are you changing the eye or unchanging eye? Deep inside you know I am unchanging eye, right?
Yes.
Huh? That unchanging eye is only one universal. And that's called Bhagavan. That's called God. That's called Shiva. So what are you? Shivoham.
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 Ramana Shivoham.
Ramana Shivoham.
Ramana Shivoham.
Ramana Shivoham.
Ramana Shivoham. Then where is this confusion part coming from? I.
Because we don't know whether it's one I or multiple
eyes,
everybody says I.
Yeah, everybody says I. But that I is universal. Everybody makes a claim that it's not changing. Mm-hmm. Every part of the world they're saying I. Mm-hmm. Right? So, I is a name, right? Mm-hmm. So the name is pointing to one thing,
one
entity.
Huh? Right now for us it is like one letter which is
one?
I, which is one entity.
Ah.
You don't know, it's the same entity that I am different to and you are different to.
Then everybody should say, there are only two parts, changing and unchanging, right? And everybody knows that there is an unchanging part. the unchanging part is universal. As a part of their experience, everybody has unchanging part and changing part. Unchanging part, everybody says, I have unchanging part.
But I still cannot see you as the same as me.
No, you don't have to see. You don't have to see. You means me, me, this body is you?
Yes.
Huh?
I don't know. It's about the body.
No, it's not about the body. Mm-hmm. Can you see your eye? No. Let me see.
No.
Eye cannot be seen. Eye is only known as eye. So my eye is also known as eye. Then only you can make inference that that's so everybody is claiming one eye, which is not changing. That eye may not be many. You cannot see it. Microscope cannot see it.
Can we experience
in
this body as I? What I'm asking is,
that is the same universal life that I'm referring to as I. Is that how to experience?
I don't have the experience of universal life.
No.
I call as I.
You know, I only is there, no? Which you are confident, right? Changing. That's the experience. Your confusion is only with respect to changing I. Universal I, nobody has confusion. Because everybody claims that I am unchanging I. Everybody claims that I am sky. There's no confusion. Unchanging I, there's no confusion at all. But it's confused with the changing I. That's the confusion. Huh? Got it. Explain to her.
Yeah.
Explain. What is that?
There is nothing I. Only consciousness is there. We are pure in consciousness. If we know that consciousness is I, so there is nothing is there.
That's all I. Then everything else what you are getting is a part of the social program you call is I.
Maybe one that's social program comes loose from the real nature, probably when we get to know that universal part of it.
Don't you know now?
No.
Are you changing eye or unchanging eye?
Unchanging.
I am also unchanging eye. Can you show me your eye?
No.
I cannot show my eye. There is only one eye, invisible, that cannot be seen.
Right.
Okay. But problem is we are confusing with the body. Atma cannot be seen, but Atma is experienced all the time. That's the only experience we have. Rest of the experiences are confusing experiences, society and other programs. Madam Heavy? Who was in Gurgaon? So I'll tell you a story. Mirabai was thrown out of her kingdom. Okay? There are a lot of palace trouble in the palace because she was chanting Krishna's name and all. She was thrown out of the kingdom. Then she decided to go to Vrindavan. She traveled to Vrindavan. Okay? And in Vrindavan, there was a saint called Goswami at that time. She wanted to meet Goswami. She sent a note, I want to meet you. Then Goswami sent a note that we are Goswamis, but we don't meet women. Okay? Because they are monks. They are not supposed to meet women. She sent back, Stri, we don't meet Stri. Then Mirabai sent back a note. Okay? I thought there is only one Purusha. And everybody is Stri. That one Purusha is called Krishna, Purushottama, the I, the consciousness. And everything else is three. Three means Sattva Guna, Rajoguna, Tamoguna. Three gunas called Stri. If you think you are a body, you are a Stri. That is the way. Okay, this Stri and Purusha in Kannada is actually corrupted.
Understood.
One who thinks that he is a body, he is mixes himself with the body which is consisting of Sattva Guna, Rajoguna, Tamoguna. Such a person is called Stri. And then only one Purusha is there, which is I, Purushottama, Bhagavan Krishna. So that was just now he was claiming that he was in only Gurgaon. And he was saying he was in Calcutta. And that lady is saying, which place, madam, you are from? Which place?
Bombay.
That one eye which is called Purushottama was in Bombay, one Calcutta, and Gurgaon. And that is only I. That is called Sri Krishna. That is called Paramatma. That is I. Now, whatever I call as I is a mismatch of all social programs, bundle of programs. The moment I call as myself as body, in literature, in Vedantic terminology, you are a stri, women. Now, stri and purusha is not with the body, but are you associated with the sattvaguna, rajoguna, tamoguna? Then stri. If you are associated with conscious, you are purusha. And only one purusha is there, I. That's why everybody in the world claims I. Sri Krishna said, come to I, come to me, means understand the I as yourself. Now what has become yourself?
Inner I.
Oh, which part of the inside? Tell me.
Inner eye.
Now, where is that inside?
Unchanged eye.
The inner means you have to show me inside. Which inside?
Yeah.
Where is inside?
Universe. Totally.
I mean, universe is inside you?
Yes, of course.
Huh?
Everywhere.
No, you said inner eye. I want to know which part you are referring to as inner, means I'm saying. The eye is neither inner nor outer. It is everywhere. That's why it is in Calcutta also, in Bombay also, Gurgaon also. So can you claim that his inner eye is Gurgaon?
Inner eye. It was in my this particular inner eye, maybe
we can say. So you have to say you are a body. Agree that you are a body, then you will say particular inner eye.
Thing, right? Inside me.
Then inside of what? That's what I'm asking you. Inside of your body?
In the mind. It's again coming from the mind only.
At the moment, mind was something was stable?
No.
The inside of what? Where is the mind?
Memory
you'll find out. Okay? The moment you understand the secrets of memory, you'll jump out of your seat. So, understood everybody? So, this is the meaning of Vedantic teaching. Now, you are a human being, then are you this? This structure you call as human being. Okay? So, all the time you think, in Gurgaon when you said, my dear, you are saying this structure was in Gurgaon. Is this structure you?
Skeleton.
This is in Gurgaon. It is nicely packaged, that's all. This is the only structure. Okay, if this structure is you, okay, if this structure is human, somebody dies, the body is there, no? They should do the puja for the body and keep the body in the house.
Yeah.
Huh? No? Why don't they do it? No. Of course, you are the body, no? Huh? If you are the body should be kept in the house and do puja, no?
Once the consciousness is gone.
Then what are you, body or being?
I'm being.
Then, so why do you live your life as being, body? Then how can you claim that you are in Gurgaon? Madam, heavy up then, right? See, what are they? Unconsciously, we have picked up so many social conditioning. Okay? You have to look at them very carefully, understand what is the reality. So if you are a body, a dead body should be kept in the house and do puja, no?
No.
Because the being is not there, left. Okay, being has left. That's why you are not the body, you are the being, using the body, possibly.
Guruji, if it is left, that there is a confusion for me. It is everywhere means where it is left.
No. The being means the mind part. The mind part. The being is everywhere. What has moved is mind, which is using the, it's like controlling the body.
This is a vehicle.
Body is a vehicle. The mind is controlling that. So this mind is causing...
like a shukshma sharira or something.
Just say mind. So that is causing... mind is the one which is causing the confusion. Okay? The Atma is everywhere. The body is just a vehicle. So the mind claims that I am the Atma and say I am the body also. So that is causing the confusion. The confusion is created by the mind. Now when you die, the mind goes to another body. That's called Jiva. So then mind realizes, oh, I am not a separate entity, I am Atma. The mind merges with the Atma. ಏನಪ್ಪಾ ಏನೋ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಇದು ನಿಧಿ ಶರದಿ ಯಾಕೆ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಆರ್ ಯು ದಿಸ್ ಸೊ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ದಟ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಲೀವ್ ದೇರ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಆಫ್ ಮೈ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಮೈ ದಿಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಓನರ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಓನರ್ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಓನರ್ ದ ಲೇಡಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಶೌಟಿಂಗ್ ಮಲ್ಲೇಶ್ವರಂ Right? The moment you have the body, somebody says about the body, you feel good or bad. Hey, you look very smart. Start feeling, oh, I am the body. Right? You have become weak now. The Atma, the self, neither becomes weak nor becomes strong. Definitely doesn't put on some cages. Weight reduction is not a problem of Atma. So Atma, there's nothing to be done. Okay? Now all these tricks are the mind's mind. You are really Atma, the consciousness. Shiva Swarupi. So the way teaching of Vedanta is that you are not the body, mind or intellect, you are pure consciousness. You are the Atma. So I'll tell you what is the confusion coming from, okay? Everything in the world has a name, right? Name and form. For example, this is a glass. Any dispute is there? This is a mobile. No dispute. Everything has a name. Maybe in Kannada you lota antu kariyo. You can call one name, but one name, one form. Right? Now, if one name has many forms, or many forms has one name, is there a big confusion?
Yes.
Yes.
Right? Yes. Many forms have one name. Do you know what? Why many forms having one name? You know what's one name? That name is called I. I has millions of forms. Right? You understand? So, you give me a glass of water, means you give me a glass of water because you know what water is water. But somebody speaks of I, you don't know with which hell, with the what I is speaking of. Because I can take
too many forms.
In Gurgaon, which I was there, sir?
The beam was there.
I can take any number of forms. The husband is talking to the wife, okay, after 20 years of marriage. Suddenly her face changes. Now this wife I has gone. She has going on classmate. What happened to my schoolmate? That schoolmate I has come inside. Husband doesn't know. Suddenly her face has changed. Okay, she thinks, wow, what a nice school days and what the hell am I doing after marriage? Already I has changed inside. The husband is thinking that he is talking to the wife. But then she is actually there, she becomes a schoolgirl. And wife is thinking that she is talking to the husband. Okay? Husband is actually watching the cricket match. Black box. So, the communication is happening to eye to eye, a transaction line. These are constantly changing, the names and forms. At any point of time, you don't know which I you are speaking to. This is called Maya. This is called Samsara.
I'm Chinese speaking also.
So, tell me, sir, in Gurgaon, which I was there? Calcutta? Huh? Which I was in Calcutta? I was there, some I was there, but which I? 15-year-old young gun?
Those masks.
So who was there in Bombay?
Young lady.
Okay. So it can take any shape, any form. It's chuck and it'll change the shape. When you're talking within a minute, that